Your speaker is not working properly. Recording will not end. How you doing, Bob?
Good. How about yourself?
Well, supposedly my speaker is not working properly. Okay. And it said that it won't record audio. That would be kind of a bummer.
Definitely that would.
I think so. Okay. Okay. Seems okay. Yeah, I can hear others. Okay. All right, I guess we'll see how it works or not. You know, who knows, right? Hey, Richard, how you doing?
Doing fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm good, sir. Okay, and Veronica, how are you this morning?
Good morning, doing well, and you?
Well, it's Friday, we made it.
That's right.
We survived another week.
Yes.
Well, that's not too bad. Hang on one sec.
They go by so quickly anymore.
Yeah.
You know, Bob, I've noticed that.
What? As you move forward, they'll get faster.
Yeah, I know. And, well, I mean, they're pretty darn fast now. You know,
<Right. Yeah.
laughs> it's just, you know, to the degree. And I know it's not true. Okay. But the perception is that there's just no time to get anything done. And so maybe, you know, I keep thinking to myself, well, maybe I'm getting slower, you know, because I just can't get everything done now. And that's somewhat bothersome to me.
So. My motto is the faster I go, the behinder I get.
Yeah, I've heard that one for a long time. Yeah. Yeah, and you know, I think that works in the way that if you try to rush, you just kind of, you know, you end up creating more work for yourself.
Yeah,
and that does actually have a little bit of validity with what we're doing. So sometimes you know, you like when we're doing a 2-minute gesture or something like that, you're kind of thinking, yeah, I really need to draw fast. When in fact, you have to do just the opposite. You got to draw slow. And you really got to take your time and look before you make a mark. Because otherwise, you end up making a funky looking draw. So, anyway.
Hi, Susan.
Hi, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
No. Susan just popped on. Okay. Let's see if I can test it too. Without, okay. No, I did. For whatever reason, I can't touch this bottom bar. There we go. Without, you know, turning something on that I don't want to turn on. You know, it's kind of crazy. So, anyway. So I think we got a minute or two, right? So,
I don't know.
Okay, let's see. What does it officially say? It officially says
10:02.
It's 10:02, yeah. All right, so we're going to get rocking and rolling. And as people filter in, and both online and in person, we will.
Did you do all those faces over there?
You mean in the middle?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You did that? Yeah, those are all pin line. Yeah, I did that when we were in class one day. Yeah. Just quick sketches. All right. So last week, if I remember correctly, and I hope so, we were doing drawings, but we were separating, you know, line, you know, in other words, the quality of the line, thick, thin, hard, soft, right? As one process. And then I had to do the same drawing in the valley, right? So with that, there we go. Yay. All right, you guys seen a pyramid out there?
Yep.
Okay, good. All right. Yeah, because what was it, last week or something? Yeah, or no, it was earlier this week. We couldn't, for whatever reason, yeah, I couldn't share a screen. I don't know why that is. So when you actually combine the two of them together, this is kind of what you hope to get, okay? Is you get use of line and value, see? And I guess my question to you is, does that drawing look dimensional to you? Yeah, more or less you kind of feel like, you know, she's not flat. You know, she's got some form to her, right? Okay,
yep.
And that's what we hope for. Okay, you know, that's the whole thing. Now, there's different ways that you can approach this, okay? You can draw on a white sheet of paper, right? In other words, just take the paper and start making lines and then fill in the tones, okay? And that's a approach, okay? But I'm gonna offer you a different approach, okay? And for you guys out there, you know, in Zoom, all right, you can do this as well, as long as you're using a soft media, either like graphite, charcoal, you know. Susan, you can't do it with colored pencil. Okay, it won't work.
Okay.
Yeah.
But if, I can use it with a regular art pencil, right?
Right, yeah. Yeah, with a graphite pencil.
Okay. All right.
And so what you'll need, okay, for today, is you will need either content, you'll need paper, you'll need a paper towel, you'll need an eraser, okay? Those are the things you gotta have, okay?
I get them.
If you don't have those, well, it's not gonna work, okay? It's kind of like, that's the formula. You gotta
so
have
I will
those.
Get some paper towels for the next one? Or?
No.
Oh, you have it.
Yes, I'm going to unsecure the paper towel because they have a way of disappearing out of their room, strangely. They just go away. Like, and wait a minute, they were here yesterday. What happened to them? And that's because someone came in and walked off with them.
Okay.
But, yeah. All right, so here's a paper towel. All right. Now, so the very first thing you're going to do is on the paper that you have, you're going to take the side of your pencil or your content, and you are going to just scribble on it. Okay, use the side rather than the point. Okay, and you don't have to put a lot of pressure on it. Okay, just, you know, just get some kind of, you know, material on the paper. Okay, go ahead.
Where do you want, where on the paper do you want one of these?
Everywhere.
Yes.
Just take it, if you can turn it to the side, just turn it to the side and then
So is this just a line drawing or is it everything?
No, we're going to work in line and tone. But what I want you to do first is I want you to turn your pencil to the side and I just want you to put a tone on your paper. You know how like we do with a painting? Okay. So you just turn it to the side. And here. Just take it. Oh, okay. It doesn't have to be all even.
How much time do we have for this one?
Well, we haven't started the drawing yet. I just want you to tone the paper. And I'll give you a couple of minutes to do that.
Okay, I'm not sure what you're talking about by tone.
Okay. Susan, can you see me?
Yeah.
All right, standing here, I took a board, I took a big piece of paper, I took the content, put it on its side. And you see, I just, you know, basically scribbled all over the paper right now.
Okay.
That's all right. Then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take that paper towel and I'm going to rub it all back. And soften. Okay. Now, you know, some of the lines may not come out. You know, some of them will. Okay. The harder you rub, you know, the more you're going to get them out of there. It's just going to become kind of an even tone. Okay. Yeah. How you doing, Mark?
Fine. It occurred to me I didn't sign.
I did, I think.
Oh, certainly.
Yes. But yeah, let's try to do better today.
Yeah.
Oh, you got an eraser. Okay. Okay. Next. Yeah, turn this over to the side. Okay. I'm just trying to get it all as much of the paper covered as you can. Okay. It doesn't have to be perfect first. You can get enough of it on there. Now I can take that paper towel. Rub it back. You see, you got a little bit of a tone on it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not real dark. Right?
Yeah.
But it's quite a bit darker than the paper itself, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So you see, it in itself gives you two values, okay? Yeah. The value of the Conte, and then of course the value of the original paper. And if you take that eraser, it's just in a corner somewhere. You could use a little more Conte on here. If you take that eraser just in a corner, just try to erase a little bit. Just so you can kind of see. Okay, see if it lifts off, see how you can go back to the light of the paper again? Okay. So you see that would give you two values right there. And how many values are you trying to get?
Five, six.
Five. Yeah, at least five. Okay. So what does that mean? The white of the paper is light. Unless you have a piece of chalk, you can make it lighter. Okay. The Conte itself, when it's rubbed back, is probably somewhere around what we call a mid-tone, right? Your line, right, to you, can vary, but for the most part, it's going to be, you know, somewhere in a dark, middle dark, right? And of course, if you use that eraser and you just kind of, you know, maybe lift a little bit of that tone, you could get back to what we call a middle light. So you could have...
Hey, Charles?
Yes.
What kind of eraser is best to use here? Regular or the kneadable?
Any kneaded if you've got it. What kind of media are you working with, John?
I got the Conte.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, kneaded eraser would be just fine.
Okay. Thanks.
Yeah. If you're working with graphite, you know, like a hard rubber eraser might work better. But okay. But a kneaded eraser would work with that as well. Okay.
So either thank one. You.
All right, Linda. That's yeah, plenty dark enough. Yeah. Running on back.
Okay, so for the first step is to get this stuff on the paper, and yep. Then the second and step is to wipe it down with the towel.
Right.
And then the third step is to start erasing places.
No, well, no, I just wanted you to use your eraser on a corner just to see that you could pull it back to the white of the paper. See, just as a test. All right. So that.
So is it supposed to cover the whole page, or is it just.
You know, most, you know, of whatever area you're going to draw in. Okay. So I usually start off covering at least like 2/3 to 3/4 of the page.
I like it. Morning, Charles.
Good morning. How you doing, Amanda?
I'm doing good.
You're here, right?
I'm here, yeah.
Yeah. You're not underground, right?
Again, but I will be soon.
Yeah, you're being seen. Harry, what do you need a chair? We've got chairs right here.
Well, that's what we do.
Yes,
we do need a gentleman.
Okay. Armando, I've got a stool right there for you.
I don't know. It's going to be, you know, I'm going to use that table. I need to there.
Okay. All right. Anyway. All right. So everybody got a little bit of tone?
Yes.
I know Armando.
We're getting it on the page.
When you didn't give me
a... I'm sorry, Susan.
I'm still putting it on the page.
Okay. Yeah, we'll give you a minute or two.
Yeah.
We're not in a big rush.
So we're going to draw that lady?
No, we're not. Huh? We're not going to draw that lady. We drew that lady last week.
So if we draw that lady, if you were to draw that lady, where would you start? Is it head, the arms, or would you just.
Well, okay, let's talk about this. Okay, so the first thing I did was put a tone on the paper, and then I rubbed the tone back, right? And then the very next thing I did is I made two marks. Okay, because I kind of figured out where do I want the top of her head, which was really right about in there, and where do I want, you know, how far down am I going, which was really kind of right in here. So I just made two little light marks. Okay. So I knew the size I was going to make my drawing. Okay. So what was the next thing I did? All right. Well, I looked for, what is she doing? Okay. And since she had her arms up over her head, that kind of made a triangle, didn't it? And so what I did is I made a triangle, just very lightly, you know, just kind of a triangle. Okay. And then I drew a center line. Okay, and I drew a center line down through her head and right through her chest and right through her body, which was not a straight line.
Oh, not a straight line.
No, it was curved. See, because what's happening with her head? So your head's going this way, and then you get to her neck, and then it begins to go this way, right? So it's got a thing, right? And again, all of this is very light, so that as you draw and erase, guess what happens? It disappears. It just kind of blends into the
concept.
Okay. Magically.
There, you could
use
it a little more. Well, this paper doesn't look easy. No, it doesn't. It's not
ancient. Well, we didn't see when I've been playing with this
print over there.
Oh, well, here. I can fix that for you.
No, no.
So this paper we're using is called newsprint?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, somebody grabbed this white drawing paper, which we're not ready to use yet. It is not out. I have things out because they kind of work together.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, that's okay. So here's two drawing boards. Let me put a little more on this. A little short. Okay, here you go, Linda. We'll try this instead. Here's an older board.
Okay.
There you go. Here's an older board. Yeah. Let me have the clip. Just put it back on here. Must be because of you. I can make it bigger.
Brighter.
I can't make it brighter. I don't have a way. Yeah, I don't really have a way of adjusting.
Are we supposed to be drawing her yet?
No.
No. Yeah, we're not drawing her. I'm just using her as an example. Okay. Okay. We're not ready to start drawing yet because everybody's still trying to get ready to draw.
Susan is in a speedy mood this morning.
Charles.
Yes, John.
A waiting period. I had trouble logging in from the link and I had to go back to the PDF that the defendant sent in.
You had trouble logging in
with the links you sent.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but the one on Sabrina's PDF, they work.
Okay, as long as they work. Yeah. Hmm.
I got kicked out right when I signed in this morning. And I
did
had
you?
To go back and do it again.
Huh.
When I signed in on the ones you sent, it said waiting for a host.
Oh.
And then when I went back to Sabrina's on the PDF, it came right into the class.
It's funny because it should be the exact same link. Because they got their links from me.
Yeah. But I don't know.
It's the opposite. When I use your link, you come up.
Okay. Hey, as long as you get here. Yeah, we're not drawing that picture. Okay. Just rub that back. Okay. All right. So is everybody ready? Everybody get tone on their paper. All right. Everybody taking. Just in a circle. Yeah, and look. Yeah, and you may not get rid of all the ones.
It's fine. It doesn't matter.
No.
Okay. Thank you. Barbara, you didn't tell me I have to go to the pharmaceutical.
Yes, Mabel?
Yes, can we remove some of this?
Can we what? Can we remove some of it?
Yeah, well, yeah. When you're rubbing it back, that's kind of what you're doing.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh, there goes my doorbell.
Yeah, so look, don't turn this. I know. It's my favorite board. The problem is the board. It's not stiff enough.
Oh.
Okay. You could make a little difference.
It's a big difference.
Yeah. You know, of course, you know. Okay. Now you want to be gentle with this.
It is only one.
And paper.
A long time ago, we had another conversation.
Yeah. Okay. All right. There we go. Now we'll just set this aside.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Get it out of the way.
Yeah.
All right.
Take it out.
Oh.
Thank you, sir.
Now, why?
Yeah.
Now, run off the stuff. All right. There we go. Okay. So, you guys ready to draw now, right? Everybody's got tone. All right. Everybody's taken a kneaded eraser up before and just tested it to make sure you can lift off, you know, this stuff back to white. See the difference? Good. Okay. All right. So, away we go. All right. Now, we are going to start off with a very slow drawing, okay? We're going to draw this in two 20-minute segments, okay? The first segment, all I want you to do is I want you to draw it in line. the next segment, when we come back, then what we'll do, we'll use the eraser, we'll pull out the lights, and we'll add in the darker values. Okay? Guess what that gives you? Just like that. Okay? It's magic. Okay? All right. So we're going to do a long drawing, and we're going to talk about drawing on toned paper, if I can get by everything.
No,
we don't want to do that. No, well, we're not drawing my drawings. These are examples that I'm going to show you, but we got to get to what we're going to draw, right? Not her.
We're going to draw the line drawing over our...
Over the tone.
Tone. And then, yes. use the same page to take out the highlights.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, you're going to use the same page, and then you're going to come back with the eraser, pull out the lights.
Right.
And then add the shadows.
Okay.
Okay? All right. So everybody see?
Our line needs to follow the rules of thin line.
Yes.
Thick line.
Yes. Like, this is what we're going to draw. Okay. So what kind of line would you use on her back? And would it be the same kind of line that's under her arm? Probably not. Okay. So one has got to be darker and, you know, probably a little bit softer, where this line has to be lighter in value, but sharper.
The line on the back, yes, it should be lighter, but that's what the line...
Lighter, but also sharper.
Are we drawing just her or the whole picture with the guy in it too?
No, you don't have to put the guy in it, but if you want to, you can.
I mean, how much, you know, I mean, you got 20 minutes, right? Well, Susan wants to paint the guy, let her paint the guy.
No, I wanted to do the picture. like everybody else, okay? All right, so you guys ready to go? Okay, so you got 20 whole minutes.
Can you draw in graphite over the Conte?
No, draw in Conte over the Conte. Yeah, if you're using Conte, stay with Conte. If you're using graphite, stay with graphite. Don't mix them up.
What's Conte?
The brown stuff you got in your hand.
I call it chalk.
Well, that would not be correct. It is not chalk. It is Conte.
Well, when I went to school here, they called that thing. So.
No, they did not. Okay, start drawing.
No, I'm observing first.
You're observing. Okay. Okay. Can you see okay at this angle? You need to move the...
I'm sorry. You're fine. I don't want you to call me complainer.
Why? I already called you that.
What's new? And so, yesterday happened to me something weird.
You missed something weird?
Happened to me.
Oh, so something weird happened to you?
Yeah.
Did it involve little green men?
It didn't involve, yeah. I come here to eat lunch.
Yeah.
And I'm talking to her. I said, Barbara, remember, we have to bring something that we're going to paint. And she said, but it's today's Thursday. I did not remember at all the class.
Yeah, we were wondering where you were. I thought you maybe had to go off with one of your girlfriends and do an errand.
Well, I was with one of them, yes.
Aha! See? So you could have come here anyway. You know, such a darn one.
But you will get there when you get my age.
What do you mean? I am your age. So now again, I wouldn't just start doing an outline. Okay, what I'd do is I would just set up some simple shapes or simple lines lightly on the page. But find the angle of her body. How much she's leaning over. What's the angle of her arm? What's the angle of that leg in the front? See, And the fact is, it's not straight up and down. Okay. It's off just a little bit. See, we're going to start calling these thinking Fridays. Yeah. Because you got to look, you got to observe, you got to think. Okay, how am I going to do this?
You say we got to think? Oh, you're
yeah,
in trouble.
I know. It's a lot to ask at the end of the week.
It sure is.
I don't know, the weeks are getting shorter.
Bob and John, they are professional. They for them it's easy, but for me it's tough.
They're professional at thinking or they're just professional?
They are painters. Have been painting for years. So.
No more than you have. In fact, you've had more classes with me than either of them. What are you talking about?
Yeah, but they got other classes with other people before.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah. So guess what's going to happen in here next week? Mm-hmm. We are going to start working with a new media. Huh? We're going to start working with a new media. Uh-oh. Well, it's called water-soluble graphite.
Oh, okay. That's great.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yes.
I don't know what is that.
And you're going to be able to take those brushes, right? And you're actually going to be able to use them with some water to make tones or values, right? And of course, we're going to have to change the paper because you can't really get newsprint wet.
I bought this by chance, just interested in water soluble pastel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very, yeah. Yeah, that and like watercolor pencils, things like, yeah, they're all very similar.
All similar? Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah, they are.
I haven't seen the water soluble
graphite.
So do we have to buy them?
No. I have them.
Okay. Oh, I have to show you this.
You have to show me what? Well, draw now, show me later.
Okay.
Okay. I want you drawing. Use your time. And they can't be the same because Not Yeah, don't worry about the face. Let me suggest something. Uh-huh. You're sitting in front of these. And the reason being that if you do that, you're going to be able to see the proportions you're going to have. And you're going to find that this leg is way too small.
I didn't have it.
Yeah. But it's like we can learn to avoid down with that in front of you. It's distorted. Because it's closer to you, it looks different than the head that's more. Oh. You look down at that.
How do you go about it?
Here's a paper towel. Okay, so, gee, it's big enough. Okay, so I just rub it back, and then I draw. Well, as big as you think it is.
Okay.
But look at it.
It's pretty big.
It's pretty big. It's the same length, right, from the knee to the foot as it is from the knee to the top of the head.
Oh, okay.
See? So once you figure out where your knee is, and say it's going to be right there,
ooh,
then you know.
I did that right.
That's got to be. Yeah,
wow.
That foot in is about right there.
Oh, that's.
How about that? See, it's called comparative measuring, you know, or sight sizing. You compare one thing to another, and you're having the same problem, see, because you're drawing flat. You're making the legs too small because, you know, you're making this too big because it's further away. And so right now it looks okay, but when you do this,
and I have a man face, I could make it look like a woman. So,
well, we're not worried about the face. We're worried about getting the figure on the face and getting the proportions. All right, so let's try this again. So instead of drawing flat, let's put it on a board or on the easel and try to draw it out. That way you can see what you're doing. Okay. But what? Let's see if we can even put it in here and it won't bounce around. Right. Erase your
Charles, do we have any Leonard Skinner for us this morning?
I do have some music.
Yes.
I can't tell you that it's Leonard Skinner.
Well, it doesn't have to be Leonard Skinner.
Yeah. I mean, he's in the mix.
Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young. Somebody's
yeah.
Like that.
Yeah, there's a little of all of them in there, in the mix. But again, the reason I haven't started the music is that I'm just kind of walking around trying to help people talk. So when we get into the second part of this, I'm trying to get you guys at least with a, you know, pretty good proportional line drawing on the page.
And oh, that's not such a good mix.
It kind of depends on who you ask. Some people like some stuff, some people, that's all.
Well, that's the idea of the mix.
Yeah.
What it was.
Like I said, some of the people have some of them. You can't keep everybody happy.
Well,
it's a deep subject.
That's what happens in most part of the world. People, they want, too many people want different things.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Like in my complex. So,
yeah. Here's what's going on with you. You are trying to do what we call a contour drawing. And that's not the whole. The first thing you want to do is you want to begin to figure out your lengths and distances before you ever try to make it look like an arm or anything else, right? And the angle. So you want to find the angle of the body. You want to find then.
But it's not another angle this way.
Yes, then you want to find the angle of the arm. You want to find where, you know, maybe
or hisses, which is really maybe about there, if you have any hope of getting that neutron. And then talk to me about here. And again, the distance here to about there. Okay? So now you know your drawing will fit on the page, right? Okay. And so then you can start actually. Drawing the shapes, right? Darker on it because,
Notice on the over there, this even this is the side of the shape should be this line here is darker than this.
Yes. Yeah, because there's light. And then the head is bent over. See, at first, there's the shape. Okay. You know, you're not, see, we're not following every little bump. We're just putting in shapes, right? And so now we got that leg. Coming across. And then you've got the lid that's on top. So now you can play with, you know, all the different, you know, lines and things like that. But, you know, first we're just really finding out where. Where things go to, where they kind of meet up at. But we're also looking at the proportion, how big things are in relationship to everything else. So you got 4.5 minutes. Just a good one. No doubt. And you're going to have a whole about 20 minutes.
I can see what that round thing is there. What's it?
Oh, it's a tattoo. That's a tattoo. Yes, she had a few of them.
Oh.
Okay, now.
So that would be.
No. Look at what's going on with her back.
Well, it's like this.
Yes, and
but I can't. I can't.
You can't. Why not?
I don't know. I just. I keep bracing it.
Why can't you not move your hip back here?
Oh.
Give you the distance of that leg to me.
Oh.
And sitting down. Push that shoulder forward. Or head to the swap.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. What were they called?
You were
yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But this isn't the size of that. The size. I don't know. Well, you're making that size twice the size of that. I don't know.
Not really. I mean, look at it.
It's like one, two.
Well, it looks good here, but I guess.
Yeah, it's about.
I don't.
Yeah, it could be maybe be a little bit better, but you know.
Yeah,
it's
better. Yeah, I see what.
Make it the way you want it.
No, I mean,
it's fine.
No. I just didn't understand how you got that. I guess.
Mm-hmm. Well, I was just kind of looking at it and guessing.
Yeah.
Most
yeah.
It's like, okay, that's his size in comparison to the thickness of the bone. Right?
I'm the same.
It looks so much better than mine.
Oh, no. Go ahead.
Yeah.
There's nothing sacred. That's the first thing you got to give up. You know, there is no such thing as anything being sacred in art.
You must
yeah,
see
them
sacred.
So much
sacred.
Well, that's because we have her kind of doing what she's doing up there. She's leaning forward.
Yeah, yeah. I didn't help it.
Mm-hmm.
I said it
made it pretty. Yeah, you, well, you, yeah, it's, you got to pay attention to the angles,
yeah.
Where things are in relationship.
Right. The angle there, I wasn't making it bigger. I'm racing the same line over and over and over.
Yeah. Throw it back. And it's okay, you know?
You could rub the whole thing back.
Yeah, I've done that many times. I've done that with paintings, you know. You begin to lay out a painting and then the composition, you know, it's not quite working. What do? Do you just keep going? No. You take a big brush, you take some turpentine and a rag, rub it all out, start again. Sometimes I start paintings 10, 15 times before I
get it. But I'm painting over the painting.
No, why do that? I mean, it's oil paint, it's wet, right? If you don't have things where you want it, you know, just rub it back, put it where you want.
But otherwise, it's an old paint.
Oh, well, if it's dry, then you can just paint over it. But yeah, but if you're starting a painting and you don't have the layout the way you want it, it's really bad. Same thing with drawing. Yeah, nothing sacred about it.
Charles, do you prefer oil over acrylic?
I do, generally. Yeah.
To me, it's easier to work with oil than with acrylic.
Well, in some ways it is. You know,
especially mixing the colors.
Well, oil is a little more forgiving in the sense that, again, you have time that if the composition's not right, you just rub it out, okay, and start over again. With acrylic, by the time you make the decision that you don't like the composition, it's already dry. So you've got to paint over it, let it dry, and then start over again.
Yeah. The only advantage with acrylic is that it's easy to clean the brush on water.
Well,
that's the only thing.
Some people seem to have issues with it. That's why we get a lot of really stiff brushes. Okay, so we're going to start over. Okay. And this time, I don't want you drawing lines. What I want you to do is I want you to put in values, okay? Which means that you're either going to use your eraser to lift back from your background, and or you're going to use your Conte to put in, you know, tones. Now, where's the darkest dark on her?
Well, move a little bit, thank you.
Yeah.
On the open on the bottom arm, yes.
Kind of
yes.
Under her arm, under her neckline right here.
Yeah.
Obviously, her hair is pretty dark.
Yeah.
But also, look,
mm-hmm.
where her knee is making contact, mm-hmm. right? And then look here on her abdomen. Now, this is not as dark as maybe under the arm, right? But it's still, if you squint your eye,
yeah.
squint your eye down, and you see it makes almost like a triangle right there in that corner. Right?
I know.
And it's really pretty dark.
Below her breast, you can see the shade of the light.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a fairly dark area here.
And then
right?
The shade, yeah.
Yeah. And then see, it gets softer, you know, as it comes up and around. Okay. So the first thing I would do is I would go into my line drawing and I'd put in those strong darks. and I'd get them as dark as I can, okay? And then after that, then I would take my eraser and I'd pull out the lightest lights. That's what you've just done. You just created a range of value. And so that you know that every other value you make is going to be between those two extremes, the really dark and the really light. Okay? Now I'll turn over. Why?
I don't have anything else to say.
Let's see if we can find it.
Probably from the void. So these people will feel young again. Do you like musicals?
Do I like what?
Music from musical.
Not particular. Some, you know, but I'm not like a huge, you know, give me a music.
Oh, I love musical.
Yeah. I should get together with my brother. We can hang out and watch musical together.
Where is it, Charles?
Pardon?
Where's your brother? In Atlanta?
Yeah, he's got a house in Winder.
I heard that town, but I don't know where it is.
He's going to die.
He's, oh, okay.
Yeah, you know where the big winery is out there? He's going to die.
No.
Mm-hmm. Okay, not far.
I've never been in that. Well, it's not highway. If the big highway going that way.
Yeah, they do. It's called Highway 85. Pretty darn big.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Pretty big.
In some media, we have Highway 16.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's good music. No, Mick Jagger.
Yeah, so we'll use that. In the grinder. First of all, this is a free bar with elbows. Yeah, sure. I'll follow the camera.
It's a jigsaw puzzle.
How do you get all the parts to work together? Yeah. You want that? You want that? But physically, in other way, yes, you have to be transparent.
Really?
Well, yeah, because you are our instructor.
But now you might want to, before you do that, Armando, you might want to sit and squint your eye down and ask yourself, is the light part of the body lighter than what's behind it? Or is the thing behind it lighter than the body?
Well, right now, if my wall foot is lighter, just the wall on the cabinet.
I would disagree. Yeah, actually, if you squint your eye down, this area is much lighter than that
by about 2 values. That's on a 10-value scale. Now, when it gets right to the edge where they meet, they're about the same value. Because you see, it's a little bit darker here. Not anywhere near as dark as like scattered. So, question is, yeah. Not to be honest, a but what you might think about this is this. You got a big press, and then here on the other part of the leg, here on the calf, and then your bone will be out of the and towards the fresh area, and then on the side of the foot. Okay, so you see how you're doing that? Now you've got 1, 2, 3 down. Now you've got to fold them up. So what you might think about doing is like the press is away. Here, it's a little dark. It's very light.
Charles?
Yes, John.
How can you control the degree of lightness with the eraser?
By the amount of pressure you put on it.
Okay.
If you could use it like you're stippling, like let's you are you using a kneaded eraser?
Yes. Uh-huh.
Okay. Yeah, so then just push it around and make it into a point, right?
Okay.
And then take your eraser and very lightly, see, just start lifting back. You don't have to push real hard with it. And see, the harder you push, the more material you're going to lift off. The lighter, the slower it's going to go, right?
Okay. Okay, thank you.
Yep. That's what we're here for. Answer those questions.
Sing at all.
Yeah, the words are okay, but I don't like the melody.
Anybody know who this is? I bet you don't. Huh?
Will you leave us alone?
No.
Is
that someone you know from us?
Oh, yeah.
No. At one point in time, he was called the poet of music, and he was more popular than Bob Dylan at about the same time.
Bill Withers, is it?
No, his name is Rodriguez. Yeah. And a funny thing happened. It's like all of these musical acts hit the big time and got really rich. He never did. His manager ended up cheating him out of all of his money. And then 40 years later, just by a fluke, some guy from South Africa found him.
Yeah, there was a movie on him.
Right.
In Detroit.
Yeah, found him in Detroit.
Uh-huh.
He had never known that he had gone like multi-platinum worldwide with this song. Literally billions of dollars worth of record sales. He never got a penny of it. So now he gets on a plane several times a year, flies to South Africa, and does a live concert. And obviously he hit them.
He couldn't get that money out of his manager?
No, his manager was one of these guys from Motown who went to LA and ended up cheating a lot of artists out of their money. And this guy is like super wealthy. And they tried to nail him every way they can, and they can't get a hold of him. All right, so that's it. Okay, so guess what we're going to do now? We're going to take a break, okay? I want you to take like 10 minutes. Go get some water, go get some coffee, stretch, get away from your drawing. And when we come back, we're going to do another one.
Did you see that movie?
Yeah, I did.
That was incredible.
Yeah,
I
it was.
Movie.
Yeah.
What's the name of the movie?
Was it a made-for-TV movie? I don't
No, it was a documentary.
It's the name of the documentary.
It was called Rodriguez.
Just Rodriguez.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's such a girl.
But I mean, like in the New York Times and stuff, they wrote this guy up because I mean his lyrics and his writing ran circle around Bob Dylan.
Really
did. I mean, he's got some.
Bob Dylan just won the Nobel Prize for poetry, right?
Right. Yeah.
Another interesting art room is called Bug Eyes.
Oh, yeah.
It's about Howard and Margaret Toone.
Right, yeah. Yeah, the woman who painted all the little children with the big, big eyes.
Oh, yeah. That was a good movie about her.
I saw that. Her husband said he did it.
Yeah.
Yes. Such lies.
Yeah, that was a really good movie.
Okay, I have a request. Okay. During the break, I want everybody to come over here. Here's a piece of paper and a pen. I would like you to sign in. I want you to write your name and your phone number. Okay, Barbara Baker, go ahead and be first. Yeah,
When I was in Germany, I found this thing of water based pasta, which I thought very interesting. Also, it suits our body better. Mm-hmm. Anyway, they are going to conduct two classes next week, so I'm just going to see what the best pasta.
Okay. Yeah, well, there's different, there's water pasta and those are mainly soft pasta.
Oh, I'm going to return you this book that I borrowed from you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Everybody staying out of trouble over there?
Nope.
No? Good. Good. You need to act up as much as you can.
I did. I agreed to do a portrait.
Yeah? Somebody. Yes. How's that working out?
So far, it's interesting. I'm doing color studies at the moment before I put it on a big canvas.
Good.
And trying to work out all the problems on, you know, ahead of time. And it's interesting because my reference photo obviously is crappy.
Okay, fine. Well, you know, the good news is that, you know, you're working it out, and, you know, that will make your life considerably better.
Yes. You're not the first person to tell me that.
Yeah, I'm sure Ernest.
Charles.
Yes.
Susan. I really enjoyed this. This was fun.
I'm sorry, what?
This was fun. I enjoyed it.
Oh, okay. How about that? See? We can actually have fun doing this.
Yeah.
Not so bad, huh?
I mean, I enjoy most of the stuff, but this was extremely just.
Okay. Very well, you're going to get to do another one. Okay.
If you have not done so, please sign in.
Come tomorrow, or the man will watch the game. The bulldog game.
I didn't say anything. It's not for me.
No, from the center.
Oh, okay.
The center. Oh, no, this is fine. Sorry.
Okay.
So you want to go to Athens and watch the Bills again?
No. This time I'm over for me. Stop party like the 18 or 20 years ago.
I see.
Now in this one, we're gonna do the same, and we're gonna.
We're gonna do the exact same thing. Okay. So I want you to write about the time before we begin. Spend a little bit of time toning your paper and start getting ready for the next drawing. Okay.
Now, y'all know that we have a party at 17.
Okay. Now.
That you have to confirm at the front that you're gonna come to that party at 17.
So the party assignment, many times, many black. Barbara, Green, Harry signed in, Mason signed in, Linda signed in, and Barbara Fisher signed in.
Here in the United States, you have to wake up, or the other way people run over you.
It was quite that bad.
No, it's because you found people from so many different places in the world.
All right. Should be toning your paper.
Oh, okay.
And Linda, don't. Yeah, not quite so great. You can, you know, a little bit lighter.
Okay.
Yeah, and then just rub it back. And you'll get it kind of nice. You're getting some material on there. You're going to make it really dark.
In the shadow of the tallest building, I bowed out with faith to me. Listen to the Sunday actors. But all they would ever.
You guys out there in video land, you should be toning your paper as we speak as well.
Well, I don't have this thing at home. Is that right? If I do this flat and zoom, how am I going to do this?
Use pencil.
Pencil? Okay.
Graphite. Or get you some charcoal. Or,
it really works beautifully with charcoal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No more charcoal, are you good?
I mean, I'm good. You know, when I have a house over in Valley, Alabama, and I was out burning a bunch of trees, you know, that I, after I burned everything in the barrel, I emptied up the barrel and I took the charcoal brick and the leftover, and I broke them up and I used them for, I shaved them down as a drum. So,
I need an eraser can.
How are we doing out there in TV land? We got tone paper ready?
Oh, yeah.
Good. All right. So we're getting ready to start drawing.
Hey, Veronica.
Mine's not ready yet.
I'm sorry, what, Susan?
Mine isn't ready yet.
Okay.
Well, hi, Veronica.
Good morning, Armando.
Do you have a music file from Tennis?
Santana, yeah,
I do. I got a little bit of everybody.
How you doing, Susan?
I'm just about ready. Okay.
All right.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. All right. So we're gonna get started. There you go. All right, now notice, okay. Take a minute. Look at what's going on there. All right, is she really vertical? Kinda, but kinda. Look at her back. So the upper part of her rib cage and things, her shoulders are back, the point of her rib cage is forward, right? Mm-hmm. And then from there, it goes back at an angle to her hips, right? It's almost the same angle as that leg, right out there. And then this leg is really moving pretty much over vertical. Okay. So just keep in mind where things are. Start off with a line drawing. And again, it's not a contour line. You know, you can start off with two marks. How big am I going to make my drawing, right? Make a mark at the top, mark at the bottom. Okay. And that's where you're going to put your figure in between there, right? And then figure out the angles, okay, and the length. How long is it from her foot to, say, you know, the bottom of her buttocks, right? And then how long is it from there to the top of her shoulder, right? And then you just have the head to add on, right? Because these two lengths, from here to here, and from there to the top of the shoulder, magically are the same.
I've lost mine. No, that's yours. That must be.
went home.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. So for everybody in the room, I want you to stand up out of your chair. And I want you to walk around and I want you to just leave your drawings laid out, you know, in your chair. Walk around, look at whatever you want. Okay? Don't move. Stop drawing. You're going to get another 20 minutes of this. Come on, Terry, Linda, everybody, up on your feet.
Okay.
You're going to do something.
You're going to go water the plant?
No. You're a plant killer.
I'm not. I didn't put the fork in it.
You're coming to water for 5 minutes.
Thank you.
Then you bring your water.
Your proportion for getting started.
Faces are the hardest things for me. I can't see through the
people. Well, so,
faces.
Yeah, well, we're not doing faces, so don't do one. Yeah, just
sort of an outline on her face, though.
Yeah, well, I mean, if you get the front plane and then break the front to the side plane and where the light is, that's enough. You don't see all the little nuances of the features. Okay? For everybody out there in Zoom land, do the same thing. Get up, move. You've been sitting too long.
Do some aerobics.
That's right. You know, give yourself just a few minutes to get away from the drawing. That way, when you come back, you'll actually be able to see it. Okay? Come on, Bob.
Well, I'm drinking coffee.
Okay, but yeah, get up, move around. Yeah. We don't want to sit too long. Okay. We're only going to take a couple minutes, and then we're going to go back to it. Okay, all right. So now we got 10 more minutes, okay, on this post. That would be the end of the class.
Is that where he's sitting? Yeah. Yeah, he's the idea of it. Oh, that's Charles's drawing, of course. I should have known. Yeah, I have decided to.
Here we go. All right, you guys ready to go back at it?
No.
We got 10 more minutes, and then we're done.
We're gonna work on this.
Ready? And here we go. Thank you.
Unfortunately, they're not as far.
Yeah, there really is no face. You know, it's just a couple of values and shapes. Barbara Green, you speak at Adams?
Yeah. Okay. I have a back trouble. I can only sit from there. So thank you very much for putting that on target. Yes.
Yeah, you're making some progress there.
That's important. Thank you.
So alternate on Sarah this morning, so alternate is the same as Grace Jar, I can ask. Well, it just so happens that Sam Springstar is on international satellite radar.
Okay.
So it's like
so he's from St. Spring?
Yeah, he's from Joe Walter.
Oh, okay.
That's the concert over here in this big St. Spring Hall.
Mm-hmm.
And at the Brennan. It's like the Brennan. Brennan has a national theater.
Any musician that will get out and play, get paid for it. God bless him.
Absolutely, God bless him.
Visual artists, they have a hard enough time. Musicians. Musicians and writers.
Hmm.
I should say novels.
So I'm through it, but newscaster who is so popular is having a book signing and a talk at the History Center next Wednesday. It's a good book, fiction based on truth.
Only the names have changed.
Well, he's a new staff. He knows how to do that.
Mm-hmm. I saw him last night. It was pretty interesting. And it was on YouTube. So it was actually through PBS. PBS did a
a series of reports in Russia, you know, with Russian journalists directly with them. And they were smuggling out, you know, footage and stuff like that. And the journalists were documenting the protests in Russia about the Ukrainian war.
Wonderful.
And a lot of these people, you know, artists, writers, you know, things like that, showing up to protest, you know, they're basically throwing them in jail and keeping them, you know, and taking forever to get them to trial. I mean, it was, one young woman, she's been locked up for almost a year.
A journalist or from?
She's an artist, but she did an art piece. And what she did is she printed out all these labels. And then she went into a grocery store and she put her labels where the food prices were. And what the labels basically said is, you know, on this day in Ukraine, you know, so many Russian soldiers were killed in Ukraine. Mm-hmm. And so she put those all over the store. Well, they came picked her up. And,
I think so.
Yeah.
She'll never see the light of day. Uh-huh. Is she ever go?
Well, she had a trial, kind of, sort of. It's funny, you know, it's like they grade everybody in there, right, for the trial. And then it's kind of like they throw them all out of the room. And for 5 hours, you're standing outside while, you know, the state is presenting its case against this woman. And then everybody gets to fall back in to hear the verdict. You know. So you don't really get the much for the trial.
So she's found innocent, right?
No. Well, we don't know.
That's 20 years.
Yeah, we don't know what she's going to be found because the court basically, you know, is going to keep her incarcerated, but they haven't come to a decision. And so you could be waiting for that final decision. That was
20 years.
But they literally have, like, thousands of people killed where they were interviewing this one college professor. And then he finally got arrested and lost his position at the university. Basically will never be able to work, you know, in Russia again. And he has his mother and his father are in Ukraine in one of the cities being bombed. And so he's talking to them and they're showing the videos of these cluster bombs coming in and blowing up outside their apartment. And, you know, they're both in their 80s and you know, it's like the father, it's like, I'm not going to the shelters, you know, I'm not going to go hide, you know, it's my time, I'm staying right here, you know, this is home. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. It's kind of crazy to me.
My neighbor's come 3 hours from Russia, mm-hmm. And when she came here, when she was there, she didn't even have a bank account. She didn't know what a bank account was. She means nothing. I mean, but then she's still very much, you know, because everything you hear, she tells you everything you hear about Russia. Parents are there, and she said, why don't you go with them to the mother? Because she has a United States passport.
Right,
she said,
right.
They would never let her in.
Well, they never let her out.
She's trying to get her parents to go to Turkey. They won't go. Because they're probably, in their 80s. They're probably not, you probably won't let them back in either.
Right.
You better. It's terrible. Oh, I want to trust them.
All right, everybody. That's it. Happy Friday.
Yeah,
thanks,
yeah, thank you.
I think it's supposed to be
Friday.
Weather this weekend.
What?
The days are supposed to be like in the 70s.
Uh-huh.
So get out and get some sunshine. Okay. You know, go out and draw.
paint, working on your suntan, whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. Don't forget to confirm for the 17th. We're gonna have free lunch.
Yeah.
The manager and the girl back up. The other one will.
Oh, that's not what we want. No, cancel. No. All right, Susan. Take care.
Nice weekend.
All right, screen share that. What? Okay, that's not what we want to see. Stop share. All right, let's try it again. Screen share. That is what we want. Share.
Thank you,
Charles.
Okay, you're welcome. Stop sharing.
Charles, the other day we're reading something.
Yes.
And then they were talking about color, mm-hmm. value, line, shape.
Yeah.
Form, texture, and space.
Yes, that's the first week from this class. Yes, that's from the first week in this class. Okay. Anyway, bye everybody out there in Zoom.